Because there are different levels of enjoyment. Remember one thing. There's gross sense enjoyment, mental enjoyment, intellectual enjoyment, and ego enjoyment. Remember one thing. Every level. Now, sometimes people call, though this course is going on. Veneka, this yoga today they are doing for the body. That is the lowest level of happiness which they are getting. Then some people do meditation. That is some kriya they will make, something they will make. That is all mental level. That is also material. Someone will read books and get knowledge, and knowledge they'll feel very good. That is intellectual on the buddhi level. That is also material. Someone ego. Finish my ego. I am nothing. Why do you want to become nothing? Because I want to become everything. Why do I want to become nothing? Because I want to become everything. Oh my God, the highest ego. Want to become, I am God. What else, what bigger ego can you have than this? Tell me one thing. That ego, highest, and then comes. Ultimately, the real is the soul. When you understand the soul, then you understand that I am the servant of the Lord, and my place is Vaikuntha. And that's what actually Jannat says. Jannat is there, heaven is there. These are all places that are talked about. So, do you have? So Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita, A Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avartino Arjuna. A Brahman, Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punar Avartino Arjuna. You'll have again there also Punar Avartino. You'll again have to come into life, birth and death. Brahma's loka is the highest in this material world. So sometimes he will write their father, Swargavasi. He doesn't know where to send his father also. In Swarg you die. In Swarg the best part is this. The best part is this, you are not born like you are born here. You are born straight 16 years. You don't get old. You die like that. There is what you call now, you are calling here now, live in relationship. There is no marriage. Nothing. You are enjoying. And then moment your karma finished, you there then, sitting all of us sitting like this, fall down straight with the same body, and then there is a big gap, there is darkness there. So there are jivas there who basically survive on eating the flesh of these people who fall from swarga. So they, when they eat you, then you start, you feel you get so much of suffering that tears come down from your eyes, and then the atma comes through the tears, it comes down, and then it falls into the cloud, and when the cloud rains, the rains go into the grains. The man eats the grains, it goes into his semen, and via the semen it goes into the mother in the womb. That is how the process has been described in the scriptures. So you understood, Prabhu? So going to Swarga also is not a great thing, because that is also in the material world. It is a much lower platform than Brahma, Brahmalo. So here Krishna says, A Brahma Bhuvana Loka Punaravartino Arjuna. From the highest planets in the material world down to the lowest, all are places of miseries wherein repeated birth and death take place. But one who attains to my abode, O son of Kunti, never takes birth again. That's why you must have heard, this place is known as Bhava Sagar. What is it known as? Must have heard this word. Bhava means place of suffering. It is a Sagar, it is an ocean, a place of suffering. And we are suffering from Bhava Rog. What are we suffering from? Bhava Rog. Bhava means birth, death, old age, disease. I told you the first day. Adi Devik, Adi Bhautik and Adi Atmik. These seven miseries we are suffering. You'll have to. This is not, 8 days will not be enough. You'll have to go through these lectures again and again, basically to get hold of the terminologies. I can't go again and again, has become a problem. So this is known as Bhava Rog. You have got rog. You are diseased by these things. So this is a hospital. And then you are called what? Bad Jeev. What are you called? Bad. A soul in bondage. So that hospital inside a jail. So if you want to enjoy in a hospital, what's going to happen? The disease will increase or go down? Right, Prabhu? Nay, but what happens? Right, Prabhu? You say, Prabhuji, there is an enjoyment. You're absolutely right. You have a skin disease. You scratch. You enjoy it. Oh, eczema, if you have anything, or the skin disease, if you scratch now, oh, you love it. But what happens? The disease increases. Right or wrong? Example given in the Bhagavatam. Very nice. The camel eats on the thorn bushes in the desert. And it enjoys it. But actually, things enjoying the thorn, No, he's not enjoying the thorn. The thorn pricks its tongue. The blood comes out of the tongue. It is enjoying its own blood and thinking he's so happy. The Shastras are giving examples like this, Prabhu. That's what happens with us. You're itching, enjoying. But the disease is increasing. That's what happens with children. Sometimes they get a wound and that black comes and the child feels like itching. So what do? You try to put some bandage on it. Because that time is more important. Because the moment it scratches it, now it's going to enjoy it. And then what happens, Prabhuji? Again it is open. So that is what material enjoyment is. So you are, what do you tell this? Wait. Son, wait. I will put something on it. After some time this itch will go. Goes. But spiritual thing is not like this. In spirituality, what happens? Krishna says in Bhagavad Gita. He says, when you taste a higher taste, lower taste finishes. When you take up to spiritual life, you start enjoying a higher taste, then it's not difficult to give up lower taste. Right or wrong? If you have paneer at a place, and some friend of yours tells you, there the paneer is excellent. You go there, you have there. You say, yes, yeah. Then you look at this restaurant anytime? No, you don't. Because you tasted higher taste. Gita is saying this. It states, Janam Mrityu Jara Dukhair. Janam Mrityu Budhapa. That is old age. Is all what? Dukhair. It is cause of suffering. When you leave your body, if you are not a devotee, the pain is equal to 40,000 scorpions stinging you at one time. How many? 40,000 scorpions. You say, Hastava Mara. Manega, these Yamdus are really bad. They'll make you like this. You're suffering. Simple. I'll tell you, a child loves a toy, right? Now the toy's got some sharp edges also. You don't want to have the child to have the toys, you want to pull it out. So when you pull up the toy, the more attached the child is to the toy, the more difficult it becomes for the toy to come out of the hand. And more you pull it out, the more suffering the child will go through, right or wrong? So in the same way, when the Yamduts come to take you, they put a noose around your neck. And then when they pull, because you're so attached to your body and the bodily things around you, that you don't want to leave your body. So what happens is a struggle and he pulls you out, that something like this got stuck and then you take it out. That's why 40,000 scorpions as they sting at one time.
Subscribe us on youtube.com/givegita. Like us on facebook.com/givegita. Follow us on twitter.com/givegita. Visit us at www.givegita.com. Email us at contact@givegita.com.